arrange it by ratings on the first round. Good luck.
Not about luck. Be focused, my dear.
Hi.
And girl?
Can start to class now.
Near to the drinks.
Is your match over?
Yes, I won.
Not the first. Stay focused. Oh. I love this actor. Jeez. Love her attitude. We want her to win, and of course we're proud of her. Who are you two color kid? Calm down. You're too proud of yourself.
No, hon. You won't. You can play Sizemore or Golden first.
She's gonna win. Just wait. She's gonna prove you're wrong.
Looks like we can stalk each other.
Stay focused.
Do you want to start my clock?
Come on!
Jesus Christ, Harmon, you're humiliating my rock.
You won't have to suffer much longer.
Nah! Well done, my dear.
How old are you? Never mind. Don't answer that. It'll just depress me.
Well, I'm 36.
You really are something. You know that?
She knows. I think that she has a strong ego, you know?
I'm gonna study the board a little longer.
Wow.
What happened? Something happened. What? Oh, girl, don't talk. What are you doing, my dear? I hope that it's gonna be okay. Enough, you know.
Thank you. Be there, will you?
I'll try. No, you're gonna do it. I'm into it! See, I'm really into it! What now? Yes, it's gonna begin to be annoying really quick.
I started menstruating.
Thank you for your concern.
My tranquility needs to be refurbished.
Alcohol, drugs, what a good example.
A message from Mr. Wheatley. What did he say? Has been indefinitely detained in the Southwest. Can they send me back? Do you no longer have a husband?
They won't if we lie about it.
That's easy enough.
Though I'm no longer a wife, except by legal fiction.
You can be a mother?
I believe I can learn to be a mother.
Okay. Stop drinking, stop taking drugs, don't get crazy like our first mom. Of course she was gonna remember stuff about her first mom. Her father, you know, is abandoning them. Mother who is lost. Well,
make sure I have coffee.
He's trying to play with your nerves.
What's your name?
Beth Harmon.
Nah. I think that he's trying to make you, you know, go mad. He's not even writing, you know, the things. I want to punch him! Come on, Beth. She's losing. Pierce? Fuck. One, you're not ugly. Second, you're not a trash. Something changed. She has a different way of playing. Come on, Dudley. You're playing fair. I mean, this smile was sincere at the end. With her picture.
A student at Fairfield High showed a mastery of the game unequaled by any female. And $100.
And you need to repay your friend also. Yes, my dear. She's opening that first, you know, not the dress. I'm proud of her. I don't know why, you know, but I'm feeling proud of her.
It says here that there is a tournament in Cincinnati and the first prize is $500.
Let's go!
What about school? I could write a medical excuse claiming mono. Mononucleosis. Where would we stay? At the Gibson Hotel in a double room for $22 a night?
You already...
Calculated all, there would still be a profit.
Well, they're helping each other. And did you see also that the house, it was clean during that final scene? Like now she can have a reason, you know, to get up, to do stuff and all, to be a good mother like she promised, but also she has hope for something else. That was a good episode. I'm feeling so proud. I don't know why. Did you feel the same, you know? We wanted her to win for sure because we are with her. She's the main character. We know her story. We know her past. All of what she lived. All of what she suffered. You know, really, that first episode was darker in the colors. I told you a lot about that in my intro and my review of the last episode because of the fact that it was the oldest flashback, but also the darkest flashback for all of what it meant for our past and all, for this place, but also for the addiction, the beginning of this addiction. It was Shania right there for the color, but also for the message of this episode, you know, the fact that she had her first competition and she won little by little, but she won. She met a guy also and she had her first period. And also, she won a mother, a family at first, but it was not a real family. I knew that something was wrong with him, the husband, something was wrong. She won her mother at the end, not really when she was adopted. And I'm not saying that she won her mother when she won that competition, no, no. She won her before that, when she trusts her mom, when she was nice with her, when they were helping each other, in fact, her mother accepting for her to go to this competition and to support her for that, and her supporting her mother when she learned that the husband was not gonna come back. Did I or did he leave? I'm not so sure about that. Is it really important? I don't think so. I think that it's also, you know, symbolic because it's a repetition for her, for Beth, of this same thing, you know, the fact that she's with a mother who is lost and with a father who is abandoning her. But the thing which is really great at the end, it's the fact that this second mother calculating stuff to support her, to be there for her, not to kill her, enfin, herself and her daughter. I hope, you know, for this second mother, I hope that at some point we're not gonna have an issue with the money, like the mother is gonna want more money and is gonna use her daughter for that. Because for now, they're nice together, you know, they're helping each other, they're supporting each other, they're a good team, you know, they're making a good team, so I hope that it's gonna stay like that. I can see several reasons for why maybe at some point it's not gonna be the case, but still, I want to keep up. Yeah, that was a good episode. Really, I felt proud. I know that it's logical because she's the main character and we are supporting her, we want her to win and all because we know her story and her past, but it was more than that. I was not just supporting her like, yes, you have to win, you have to win. I was also proud of her. Like, my dear, you did it! I'm so proud! Like, really, she's one of my cousins, you know, or one of my friends, and I'm like, come on, get in! That was great. She doesn't need good clothes, she doesn't need also to be sympathetic. Because really, I said at the end of the first episode that the only maybe negative thing about the first episode was the fact that she's someone who is closed, you know, who is blocked. I don't know how to say that in another way. She doesn't show her emotions. We don't know a lot about her emotions, her feelings, really what's happening into her head. She's not seeing it because of her story, really, when you are raised by that kind of mother who is crazy and who is trying to kill herself with you. I think that it's normal that after that you're closed, blocked, and you're not showing your emotions. And she's continuing to be like that during this episode. She has an ego now. An important ego, I think. She knows that she can do good stuff and that she's better than a lot of the persons that she's with, you know, in her school and all. But it's not like she's arrogant, you know, she's not playing with that and all. We just know that she knows that, you know, she's maybe a little malicious, you know, she's really like, we can see into her eyes things. And that's interesting, that's not emotions and feelings like I said, but that's emotions still, you know, that's something we can connect with her, you know, through that. I really hope also that men are not gonna be an issue. I mean, right there, she managed to stay focused and also to win against that man. I think that it's a question of ego. No matter what, she's gonna win against this man that she's gonna have in front of her. She's not gonna care about her feelings for this person because she has, in my opinion, such a strong ego. But I hope that it's not gonna be an issue. We know, we saw that she didn't have a real social life and she doesn't know a lot about boys, like what Jolene told her during the first episode, but also right there. She didn't know what was happening, you know, when a boy and a girl were kissing each other. She was not shocked by that, but like, what is that? And at the end, she doesn't know what the mono is for a girl of her age. And she's supposed to be 13 for her new mother, but in fact, she's 15, so she's supposed to know more about boys than what she knows. So I hope that her future love life is not gonna be bad because of that. I mean, she's gonna stay focused and people are not gonna try to use her, men are not gonna try to use her. I don't know, we'll see. I loved it so much, the second episode. It was really brighter than the first one, not only with the colors but also with the story, also with the characters. That second mother, you know, was in fact helping her, supporting her, maybe seeing some stuff along the episode which were not good, you know, and she has her own issues to resolve, but at least she was there and she was great for Beth, so yes, that was a good episode. So we had an evolution for Beth, we had interesting minor characters, we had an interesting story with different rhythm and all, and we had also some messages. She's taking care of herself, you know, she has this ego now and she knows that she can do good, so she's beginning to fight for it. I love that. What did you think about these two first episodes, and if you felt the difference between them like I felt, and also if you felt proud at the end of this second episode like me. It was not only really me supporting her, me wanting her to win and things like that that you can want when you are watching a show or a movie with someone into a competition and all. It was really pride, I was proud of her. That was fucking great. Tell me, what did you think about these two episodes? Okay, so it's all for you and for me for today, so it's all for me for now, so bye for now, bye!
Wait a minute, Doc, are you telling me you built a time machine?
Great!